Hello and welcome to the today's lesson on partial differentiation. In the previous lesson, we had discussed Euler's theorem on homogeneous function and we had seen some examples. So let's continue with some more examples today. Let's look at the Euler's theorem on homogeneous functions one more. If z is a function, if it's a homogeneous function of order n, then x dot del z upon del x plus y dot del z upon del y is equal to n dot z. So if this z is a homogeneous function, then we can say that this is the Euler's theorem. Now let's talk about example number 3. We had already seen example number 1 and 2 in the previous video lesson. If u is equal to cos inverse x plus y divided by under root x plus under root y, then we have to show that x dot del u upon del x plus y dot del u upon del y plus 1 upon 2 cot u is equal to 0. So let's see. Here we have u is equal to cos inverse x plus y upon under root x plus under root y. Here we can see that u is not a homogeneous function. So what we need to do is, let's consider this part as another function z. So this z is equal to x plus y divided by under root x plus under root y. Now this statement can be rewritten as u is equal to cos inverse of z, and hence we can say that z is equal to cos of u. Now we can see that z is equal to cos of u. This is one equation, and from this we can see that z is equal to x plus y divided by under root x plus y. Here, this function z is equal to x plus y under root divided by under root x plus y. This is a homogeneous function. So now we can apply Euler's theorem for this equation number 2. Now applying Euler's theorem on equation number 2, we can write x del z upon del x plus y del z upon del y is equal to n dot z. And we know here what is the n. So let me first write this function in the Euler's form. So if I write, this is z is equal to x plus y divided by under root x plus under root y. Let's take x common from here. This will be 1 plus y upon x. And let's take under root x common here. So this will be 1 plus under root y upon under root x. So now we can say this is x to the power 1. This is x to the power 1 upon 2. So this will be giving x to the power 1 upon 2 dot a function of y upon x. So now this is the Euler's form of the function. And we can say here the order is, we can see the order can be specified by this 1 by 2. So here the order of this given function, and this is 1 by 2. So now we can rewrite this. X del z upon del x plus y del z upon del y is equal to n is 1 upon 2. This is the order of the function. This is 1 upon 2 and n dot z. So we'll replace z from the equation number 1. What is z? Z is equal to cos of u. Now we need to rewrite this. X, as we know that del z upon del x can be rewritten by del z upon del u dot del u upon del x. So just by replacing this, we have del z upon del u dot del u upon del x plus y. This can also be written as, so this is del z upon del y. We can write this as del z upon del u dot del u upon del y. So now this will be del z upon del u dot del u upon del y. This is equal to 1 upon 2 cos of u. Now we need to evaluate this del z upon del u. So we will replace this del z upon del u and del z upon del u here in this equation. For this, we will be using the equation number 1, z is equal to cos u. So now as we know that z is equal to cos of u. So del z upon del u will be the first derivative of cos of u with respect to u. This will be minus sine of u. So now del z upon del u is minus of sine u. So we'll replace this. So this is minus x dot sine u dot del u upon del x. And then again this will be minus y dot sine u del u upon del y. This is equal to 1 upon 2 cos of u. Taking minus sine of u common from this left hand side, this is x dot del u upon del x plus y dot del u upon del y. This is equal to, we'll take minus of sine u common, so this will be minus 1 upon 2 cos of u upon sine of u, and we know this is equal to cot u. So now we can write this x dot del u upon del x plus y dot del u upon del y is equal to minus 1 upon 2 cot u. We are taking it on to the left hand side. This is x dot del u upon del x plus y dot del u upon del y plus 1 upon 2 cot q is equal to 0. This is what we have to prove. So now we have come to the end and we have proved what was given. So we can simply say hence proved. Let's see one more example. If u is equal to log of x square plus y square upon x plus y, then we have to show that x del u upon del x plus y del u upon del y is equal to 1. Again, let's take this u is equal to log of x square plus y square x plus y. Now, let's take this, let's consider x square plus y square upon x plus y is equal to z. So now this can be u is log of z, or this can also be right z is equal to e to the power u. And here we can see that x square plus y square upon x plus y is equal to z. This is, let's call it equation number 1, and here let's call it equation number 2. So equation number 1 is the homogeneous equation. Let me write in the homogeneous form. So if I write this, so let me rewrite x square plus y square upon x plus y. Let me take x square common from the numerator. This is 1 plus y square upon x square. Let me take x common. So this is 1 plus y upon x. So this will be equal to x to the power 1. And then function of y upon x. So here, n, the order of the homogeneous function comes to be 1. So now, applying Euler's homogeneous theorem on this equation number 1, we will be having x dot del z upon del x plus y dot del z upon del y is equal to n dot z, where n we have, this is 1, and z, we are replacing z from the equation number 2. So here z is equal to dot e to the power u. Now again we need to replace, rewrite this. So as we know that del z upon del x can be rewritten as del z upon del u dot del u upon del x, and del z upon del y can be rewritten as del z upon del u dot del u upon del y. So now let me rewrite this equation, x dot del z upon del u dot del u upon del x plus y dot del z upon del u dot del u upon del y. This is equal to e to the power u. Now we need to get this del z upon del u and replace here in this equation. Just to get this, we'll use this equation number 2. So now we'll differentiate this. Now if z is equal to e to the power u, then del z upon del u will be equal to e to the power u. Derivative of e to the power u is only e to the power u. So now let me replace this. So this is x dot e to the power u del u upon del x plus y dot e to the power u del u upon del y. This is equal to e to the power u. Taking e to the power u common, then we have x dot del u upon del x plus y dot del u upon del y is equal to e to the power u. So cancelling this on both hand side, we are left with x dot del u upon del x plus y dot del u upon del y is equal to 1, which we have to prove. So this is the proving we have to do. So now we have completed and we can say that this is hence proved. So now I hope you have understood these two questions based on the Euler's theorem. We'll meet in the next lesson with some more topics in the engineering mathematics. Thank you so much.